Acclaimed musician Nestor Torres is a jazz flautist educated in both jazz and classical music. Born in Puerto Rico, he moved to New York when he was 18. He moved to Miami in 1981. In 2001, he won the Latin Grammy for Best Pop Instrumental Album.
Sitting next to me is Nestor Torres, who's a flautist. And before I even start the interview,
yes,
I always thought that the term was flutist. So what's the difference between flautist and flutist?
Either or either. Flutist or flautist. I prefer flautist.
Okay, so then he is a flautist.
Yes.
And he's not just the musician. He's what's known in the industry as a musician's musician. Because other performers reach out to him to help them with their sound so that their sound can sound better.
I'm flattered. Thank you for your kind words.
Well, is that a true description?
I'm very fortunate that we have earned a bit of respect, and most importantly, we've been able to inspire quite a few young artists to do what they do today.
Some of the people that reached out to you ended up winning Latin Grammys and Grammys,
yes,
and you participated on
yes.
that. And I'm sure you were thrilled that they won.
Absolutely.
Now
so.
I got to ask you a question.
Proud. Yes.
Did you feel different when instead of it being one, Gloria Estefan or somebody else, the name they called was Nestor Torres?
Well, it felt very different, and I'll tell you why, because the circumstances were very unique and very different. It was to have been in Beverly Hills on September 11th, 2001. So that really changed my whole perspective and
yeah.
the whole dynamics of it. And of course, we did not received a Grammy that day or that night, but a month later. So yeah, it was very different in that it took a deeper meaning.
In 1990, at the height of his career, a celebrity boat race accident left him with crushed bones and a bleak prognosis. But as a practitioner of Nichiren Buddhism, Nestor came back stronger and better.
After that terrible accident,
yes.
you had a long recovery period, and at one time, I think the doctor said you may not be the same musician that you were before.
That was a possibility, and so...
So what did you do?
Well, this is where my Buddhist practice kicked in, and that's when I discovered what the meaning of Buddhahood is. When you're in a situation in which there's no hope, at the time the accident, I ended up with 18 fractures in my ribs, both broken clavicles, a collapsed lung. I remember the x-ray technicians being like excited, look at this, you know. They saw that my left scapula or the shoulder blade had been fractured.
Wow.
And, you know, which is a very, very difficult, very hard bone. It's very, very difficult to break. So, I was literally crushed in my upper body. And fortunately, my lips were okay and I didn't receive head injuries, although there was concerns about that for a minute. And so physically, my career, the person that I was married to at the time, which was my manager, she also went off on a whole other, she went off the reservation, so to speak. And so here I had nothing. And the Miami Herald and the New Times, they found out about it. They came and interviewed me. I'm reading this article. It was a full page, like two full pages of the Miami Herald. And I'm reading this, the story about, didn't know if it could be played again, the medical bills are piling up, there's no work, and wow, and I know this to be true, and I said, wow, that's me. And then it really startled me, said, I realized that I was reading my own story, and I knew it to be true, but I was okay. My life was okay. It was not a sense of, what is going to happen now, oh my gosh, but rather, oh, wow, this is what I need to deal with, this is what I have to contend with. And so Buddhism is about win or lose. Life is about win or lose. So I have two choices. I either win or I lose. And so I chose to take one option off that table. I have to win no matter what. So that's how I dealt with it, and it's a process that, in a sense, continues. And I just have a renewed sense of appreciation, and which I have to constantly renew,
yes.
because we forget how fortunate we all are. But that's what that was.
What's in the future for Nestor Torres? You're back, your music is great.
We, you know, have two new CDs. Relatively, you know, the most recent CDs is one of them is jazz called Jazz Flute Traditions. And the other one is a groundbreaking classical record entitled Del Caribe Soy.
You've played for world leaders,
yes.
Royalty. You've played with royalty in the entertainment business.
Yes.
What was the most impressive event that impressed you personally the most? Say, look where I'm standing and look who's over there.
Wow. The Grammys with Gloria would be one of those. One other time was performing with an array of everyone from Tony Bennett to Tito and Gloria, Herbie Hancock, Wayne Shorter. We were at the Kennedy Center, hosted by Vice President Gore at that time. That was a pretty impressive event. But if I'm really going to be candid with you, Stewart, one of my highlights in my career are not necessarily on the stage playing with all these famous people, but rather it was at a Grammy in the Schools event I was part of, whereas they brought in several buses of different students, you know, from different high schools. You know, there's always one student that is kind of like the rabble rouser, the one that really, you know, likes to shake things up a bit. And so I handled it as best as I could. And then I talked about what is the meaning of being a star. I asked them, what do you think is a star? Was somebody famous, somebody rich, somebody who's on TV? Then I went to really describe what a star is, which is a body of mass and energy that burns itself until there's nothing left. And, you know, that they give light, and that light sometimes remains, you know, longer after they themselves are no longer. And so, just like that star, there's a body of mass that burns itself. We too could become stars when we burn our energy to serve and to illuminate the lives of others. And so, you know, it's also like being a teacher, doing this is helping a star. Yes, absolutely. So at the end of the session, I'm saying my farewells and thanking them. And then this young man, the troublemaker, raises his hand and says, well, I'd like to say something. Okay, what would you like to say? Well, you know, I want to tell you that, you know, I have learned more with you in this 1 hour than I have learned in the entire year in school. So you're a star.
That
was the most, that stays with me as the greatest memory that I have in my career. So,
thank you. That's a great answer.
Thank you.